students, welcome to the chemistry session once again. I hope you all have revised your concepts which we have taken up in the last session, that is the inductive effect. How does it take place? What is the nature of the substituents which are involved in plus I as well as the minus I effect? So I hope you have revised along with ample of examples. Now let's move on to a very very interesting topic here, which is resonance, or it is also known as mesomerism. So I have got resonance here, and what actually the resonance? Just hear me out very clearly. Whenever a single particular structure is not able to explain all the chemical properties of a substance, then what happens? There is a need of more structures, and that is known as the resonance. So what is resonance? When a single structure is not able to explain all the chemical properties, or I can say just the properties, all the properties, compound, it results into the formation it demands need for the formation of several other structures. So it demands the formation or the justification of those properties which are still unexplained. So justification of other properties of all other through different structures of that compound . So basically, when a single structure is not able to explain all the properties which are related to the chemical reactivity of that compound, when a single structure is not able to explain that, how do we justify all the chemical properties? Then we have to form different kind of structures in that case. So different structures of that compound, it demands the justification of all the other properties which are left out through different structures of the compound, and these structures are known as resonance structures. So I have got one term here, or I can write it as here, the structures are known as resonance structures. Or the other name for the resonance structure is, let me just correct the spelling of resonance over here. Yes, so it is resonance structures. The other name for it is canonical structures. Or in some of the books you may find the name as canonical forms. So that is how we are going to represent the definition for resonance structures. I'm just talking about the structures, I haven't discussed resonance yet. So basically what happens here is, I have got benzene. that is benzene, and it has got what? 3 double bonds like this. Can I represent this structure in other ways? What is the other way for representation of the structure? It may be represented as the double bonds now arranged differently in a different manner like this. So both the structures are similar but having different kind of properties. Here in the case, if I talk about only the benzene ring, the properties for each of the structure will be the same, but in total it will result in the complete benzene molecule, which is like this. That is why we represent a circle in the benzene ring. That means these pi electrons keep on revolving. The pi electrons keep on revolving here inside the ring. That means I can represent the structure with a circle in the center, meaning or depicting the continuous movement of the electrons. So from here I have got the definition for resonance, which is, resonance is, in the case of an inductive effect, there was just simply a slight movement of the electrons, but here in the case of resonance, it is entire shifting of electrons or jumping of electrons. So here resonance is shifting or movement of pi electrons. So that is basically resonance is whenever there is a shifting or movement of pi electrons within the structure, within the chemical structure. So if I have the benzene ring, there is the shifting of pi electrons over here. So this shifting of pi electrons over here is nothing but the resonance. In the resonance, what happens? Electrons shift, electron moves on one atom to the another, one bond to the another. So that is known as resonance. Actually, here these kind of structures are nothing but what we have explained, what I have explained here, that is the resonance structures. These are the resonance structures for benzene. These are the resonance structures for the benzene, both of these, because independently I cannot say that this is benzene ring, yet we use it as in the chemical reactions by justifying our mechanisms, but this is not alone known as the actual structure for benzene. What actual structure for benzene is this very structure. So this is actual structure of benzene. And you know what interesting about this is, these structures, that these are nothing but the hypothetical structures. We have just made it for our own convenience. These are not at all in reality. These are hypothetical. Just to have a proper justification of all the properties, we have made these kind of structures for a compound just for our convenience. Otherwise, you all know that electrons keep on moving every time. They have a continuous movement within the atom. They are not stagnant in every case. So, due to the non-stagnant nature of these electrons, these substances, what happens here is there is a continuous movement of the electrons. If we take the example of the benzene ring, this is how the electrons keep on moving, the pi electrons. So you must have done the structure for benzene like this. The benzene is like this, and the pi electron cloud is above and below. The cloud, actually it is a cloud of electrons which is keep on continuously moving And it is not like this, that this pi bond is stagnant over here, this pi bond is stagnant. That is not how we are dealing with the benzene. In real world, the benzene look like this. And this kind of a structure, the total structure, which is combining all the resonance structures, the complete structure of a compound, or I can say a total, a sum of all the forms or all the structures that is known as resonance hybrid. All the resonance structures in totality combined to form some, or I can say the combination of all these structures is known as resonance hybrid. And this resonance hybrid is in the terms of bio, whenever you read hybrid, that is the mixture of two breeds, you can say two or more breeds. So here also the hybrid means the mixture of all the forms, all the kind of resonating structures that we can generate for a compound, that is known as the resonance hybrid. The resonance depicting the resonance structures, and hybrid means all the mixture of those structures generating a resonance hybrid. And here over here, this is the resonance hybrid actually for the benzene ring. So that is resonance hybrid. So the topic here, what we are discussing, is just hypothetical. You have to learn this topic because that is the basis of mechanisms as well. Most of the resonance structures, most of these forms are involved whenever we are dealing with the mechanisms, because mechanisms are for our convenience, for our understanding, and these are also sort of hypothetical because we have generated for our convenience, by our conveniences, certain kind of mechanisms for each and every reaction. In those mechanisms, generally, the resonance get involved. So it is a very important topic, yet hypothetical. Now, we have understood about the resonance hybrid, the resonance structures over here. Now, what else? What is actually resonance is? What kind of conditions are involved? How does resonance take place? So that is the biggest question over here, that how does it take place? How resonance takes place? So actually resonance is unlike the physics that you have read, the resonance, it is not like that, but actually resonance has certain conditions. The condition is, first of all, planarity. Second is the conjugation. And the third is a subpart for the conjugation. How? What are the conditions? What are the areas in which the resonance takes place? So over here, first is the molecule should be planar. So first is the very simple thing, that is the planarity of the molecule. Any molecule which is having a distorted structure, not lying in the plane, is not capable of showing the resonance. Conjugation means, that means I have got certain conditions over here. So see it very clearly, carefully. Double, single, double. That is the actual conjugation. This is what conjugation is. Alternations of sigma and pi bonds. So that is sigma and pi bonds. And what else? That was number one. Second is pi single are lone pairs. These are nothing but lone pairs. Third, pi single positive. Fourth, pi single negative. And lastly, pi single and a free radical. So I've got a free radical over here. So these are all the conditions which will definitely be giving the resonance. How does the resonance take place? That is the movement of the electrons, we all know. But how does the movement take place? Towards the driving force. There must be some kind of a driving force which is now conducting the whole universe. Our whole universe is dependent upon some kind of a driving force, some kind of an energy. That's why all the processes are taking place. So just like that, here also, there must be a certain kind of driving force which is driving, which is moving all the electrons continuously within a system. So those driving forces are nothing but these. These kind of conditions will be giving the resonance. So let us just take these conditions one by one and I'll explain you what actually the resonance is, how does it take place. So taking the first example, first very example is double single double. Here now initially I'm not focusing upon the conjugate, the aromatic system, that means the systems like benzene. I'm just taking up simple aliphatic systems. So first is double single double, that means there must be a conjugation just like in the case of benzene. Yes, you are right, benzene does have such kind of a conjugation. And what else? 1,3-butadiene. Can you make the structure for this compound? Yes, definitely, we have read this. It is like this. That is nothing but 1,3-butadiene over here. And what will now happen? There will be a slight, a certain kind of a movement within the molecule. Always remember, the pi electrons move. So pi electrons move. So there must be a certain kind of a driving force. So you can say, let me just give you an idea how it is taking place, then we'll try to find out a reason, a slight reason behind it, why is it happening. So there is double single double, I have got it, a pi and a sigma over here, a pi and a sigma over here, a sigma over here. Now how does it take place? These pi bonds move over here, or I can say, not first, this won't be the first step. I can say these pi bonds move here on to the, shifting onto this sigma bond. And finally, what will happen? There will be a slight distortion in the structure due to the double C and double, like this sort of a structure. So to avoid that, what will happen? These double bonds now shift onto the this very carbon atom. And I have got a structure like this. Why I'm having a double-headed arrow, I'll explain you in a moment. So it will be a positive charge created over onto this carbon, because here now the pi electrons have been removed, and a double bond generated over here against CH and CH2 negative. So I hope you now have got it, that how the positive charge and the negative charge have been developed onto these very carbons. Now, this is nothing but another kind of a structure which is possible for this compound. Why so? Because as I said earlier, that these electrons are not stagnant, these pi electrons are not stagnant, just like in the case of benzene, they keep on moving. They keep on shifting from one sigma bond, then to the pi bond, then sigma, pi. So like this, the chain continues. So that is why these electrons are also keep on jumping. Now, how to judge why these electrons, how to judge onto which direction do I have to make them jump? So actually, if you consider that this is sp2 hybridite, that is just for your information that I'm telling, that in which direction you have to go, there has to be a certain driving force. So the driving force is the electronegativity of this sp2 hybridized carbon. So sp2 hybridized, slight electronegative. That means it is tending to pull these pi electrons onto the next very, or towards itself onto the next very sigma bond. So that is how we are going to shift. So first of all, I had represented the movement of these pi bonds. Why? Because due to the electronegativity of this pi bond, which is onto the next carbon atom. Here, the shifting will be in a single direction. So that is also a condition for resonance. Just note it down. That the movement should be in a single particular direction. Movement should be in a single direction, single or same direction. It should not get crisscrossed. That means if I just try to say here that these pi bonds are shifting onto here and these pi bonds are shifting onto the opposite side, that is a very, very unfavorable structure, unfavorable phenomena which will going to happen. So that is why the resonance will always, resonance that means movement of the electrons, will always be in a single particular direction to avoid any kind of instability, to avoid any kind of unfavorability in the process. So that is how we have got one resonance structure. So this is nothing but a canonical form or a resonance structure. This time I'm writing canonical. Canonical form. Or what else can happen in the structure? Due to the attractive nature of these pi bonds, these can also shift onto this. So I can have a structure like this. So if you look here carefully, these two structures are nothing but the same. So these are same structures. So finally, in totality, what kind of a structure can I generate? So here, while generating the resonance hybrid, what do we have to look? We have to look that onto which bonds and which carbon atoms are the electrons jumping. So over here, if you look, I have got these pi electrons in between these two carbon atoms. Even in between these two carbon atoms, at some point of time, I have got at some point of a structure, I have got these double bonds. And as well as in the remaining two pairs, I have got at some point of time the double bonds, the prevalence of the electrons. So that means the resonance hybrid will be having, I have to represent it with the dotted structure. I have got the resonance hybrid like this. CH, CH, CH2. First of all, I have drawn the atoms. The atoms must be intact whenever the resonance is going to happen. So that is another condition. This was the first. Second is the atoms position must be intact. And the positions I have drawn for the atoms, what else? What do I have? I have the pi bonds or the electrons, just like in the case of benzene, I had shown it with the dotted lines. So here as well, I will be using the dotted. like this. I hope it is very well visible to you. So I have shown the prevalence of these pi electrons through dotted lines. This is the resonance hybrid. That means a compiled version of all of these canonical forms, all these structures into one. This is how we see the butadiene in the real world. Otherwise, these structures are all hypothetical. These structures only explain certain properties of the compounds, and not a single structure is responsible for all the properties, but all of them together. So all together we have got the resonance hybrid. Now coming on to these arrows. What does these arrow means? So these arrows mean that the two forms can interconvert into each other. So I have got a double headed arrow. Whenever, always remember, whenever representing the resonance structures like these, the canonical forms, you have to use the double headed arrow. And finally, whenever you are trying to represent the resonance hybrid, you will be representing it as a triple. It is not a triple bond, but an equivalence sign, kind of an equivalence sign. So here in some of the books, you might find three dashes together representing the resonance hybrid. So that is how the resonance happens. I hope you all have got the idea how the resonance is happening. What kind of a driving force is driving the electrons onto one side and having a continuous movement. So I hope it is clear to you. Now let's move on to, if you have noted down, let me just rub it off. Again, the another condition. So the next condition is over here. First was the alternating sigma and pi bonds. The next one is double, single and a lone pair. What will happen now here in this case? So if I have a structure like this, so that is the very, very basic structure having such kind of a conjugation, such kind of a phenomena. There is double, single and what about the lone pairs? What about the electrons extra? They are present on the oxygen atom. Now, what kind of a driving force will that be? So here if you see, how will the electrons move? Now actually, these electrons will be again attracted towards the pi bonds, this sp2 hybridized carbon. So this is sp2 hybridized carbon. So again, these electrons will be attracted towards it. So what will happen? These lone pairs will shift on to this very bond. And finally, again, I have got a condition like this, which is slightly unstable and will result in distortion in the molecule. So to avoid that, these pi electrons now move on to this carbon, this very carbon. And finally, I have got one of my resonance structures as this. And a positive charge onto this very oxygen atom. So these are the resonance structures. I have denoted it by the double-headed arrow. Now, what will be the resonance hybrid? The resonance hybrid will be like this. That is how we are going to represent the resonance hybrid over here. So this is resonance hybrid. And these are the resonance structures. So these are the resonance structures here in this case. Now let me just take up the another condition over here which we have discussed, that is double single positive. I hope you all have got the idea what kind of a driving force is it and how we can, in which direction. The direction is very much important here in the case of resonance. So you must remember how the electrons are moving, which is the starting or the driving force in it. Now, if I look upon to the next condition, which is double single and a positive charge like this. So over here, what kind of a driving force will that be? So as you can see here very, very clearly that the driving force will be now towards the positive charge. The electrons will now move on quickly to stabilize that positive charge. So the driving force will be here. The shifting will be like this. So I've got, this is very, very simple. I have got the resonance structure as like this. A positive here developed again, because now the pi electrons have been moved from that carbon atom, and I have got double bond CH2. So that is how we are going to represent the resonance structures here in this case. What about the resonance hybrid? The hybrid will be like this. Something like this. That is how we are going to represent the resonance hybrid here in this case. Now, I hope it is very, very clear. Now, let me take up another kind of a condition over here, which is double single and a negative charge. So, about that, we are left with double single negative and double single and a free radical over here. So, I have got double single negative, double single a free radical. So how do we represent this kind of a structure? Again, similar kind of a scenario, CH2 negative. So just as in the case of lone pairs, what will happen? I have got double single negative charge. So what is the difference, actually difference between a negative charge developed and the lone pairs? Lone pairs, actually they are existing onto a neutral atom, an atom which is in a neutral state or a bonded state. But whereas within a case of negative charge, so here the negative is coming onto the carbon atom. This is anion. This is a very reactive species. So that is how we are not calling this negative charge as the lone pairs, but it is entirely different from the lone pairs. Now, lone pairs are actually the extra electron which are present on the atom. So here what will be the driving force? Again, just as in the case of lone pairs, I have got the driving force towards the sp2 hybridized carbon, which is having higher electronegativity. So I have got a shifting like this. That is how we are going to shift in this case, just similar to double single lone pair. A negative developed over here and double bond here. So a similar kind of a structure or a scenario as we have formed in the case of here carbocations. So that is the similar scenario is being performed. What about the resonance hybrid now in this case? So the resonance hybrid will be this. Like this. So that is how we are going to represent the resonance hybrid here in this case as well. If I look upon to this one, this very double single and one free radical, what we have got? Double single and a free radical. So in this case, it is slightly different, but very, very interesting. So I have to make up one more electron. I have to give here one more electron in order to have a complete bond. So in order to have a complete bond, I must be shifting not two electrons altogether. So these pi bonds are consisting of two electrons, we all know. So not these two are entirely shifted together, but a single one. So I am shifting up only a single, and here only a single. So it will be a homolytic fission. So it is homolytic. So I have shifted only one electron. Why? Just in order to make this as a complete single bond. When two electrons come together, they will form one single bond, one single. Here in this case, it will be the pi bond. So what do I get? a free radical that has been generated again over here, and double bond over here, which is made up by these two electrons altogether. And just be very, very careful while representation of the arrows. Here the arrows are nothing but the fish arrows that I have used. Fish arrows. So that is how the resonance, the actual resonance, is taking place in between the molecules. These were the very, very basic, simple examples. And I hope these conditions are very well clear to you, which is planarity. Conjugation is the main part of the resonance, or I can say the mesomerism, double, single, double, just like we have did in the case of buta-1,3-diene, even the benzene ring, double, single, lone pairs, double, single, positive, double, single, negative, and double, single, free radicals. So in this class, what we have discussed is a very special kind of a criteria, which is known as resonance. Resonance actually is hypothetical. The structures we draw are hypothetical, and the real structure of the compound is the combination of all those resonance structures, which is the resonance hybrid here in this case. I would like to tell you one more thing over here, which is known as resonance energy. The resonance energy is basically is the energy difference between the most stable canonical form minus the resonance energy, the energy of the resonance hybrid. The difference between the two is the resonance energy. That is known as the resonance energy. The detail for that I'll be discussing in the next session. Till then, you just have to practice, just revise what we have done so far, and take care.